Good morning and welcome to Midweek with Mumbles Music Ministry. We were played in by Phil with Cavatina by Stanley Myers, which of course was used as the theme of The Deer Hunter, played then on a guitar, of course, by John Williams. We're going to be looking at the prodigal son, the parable of the prodigal son, over the next couple of weeks together. This is the first part of that wonderful, wonderful parable. Jesus went on to say, "There was once a man who had two sons. The younger one said to him, 'Father, give me my share of the property now.' So the man divided his property between his two sons. After a few days, the younger son sold his part of the property and left home with the money. He went to a country far away where he wasted his money in reckless living. He spent everything he had. Then a severe famine spread over that country and he was left without a thing. So he went to work for one of the citizens of that country, who sent him out to his farm to take care of the pigs. He wished he could fill himself with the bean pods the pigs ate, but no one gave him anything to eat. At last he came to his senses and said, 'All my father's hired workers have more than they can eat, and here I am about to starve. I will get up and go to my father and say, Father, I have sinned against God and against you. I'm no longer fit to be called your son. Treat me as one of your hired workers.' So he got up and started back to his father." There are various parts of the world where they've tried to reclaim land, some of it quite successfully, but not in huge amounts. And so that saying, the one thing they can't make more of is land, is very much true, isn't it? Land is often the reason why people have gone to war with each other, people wanting other people's land because it's more fertile. And don't forget, of course, that for the people that Jesus was talking to, the promises given to them by God, that God would take them to a land flowing with milk and honey, were very much tied up with their self-understanding, their purpose, their meaning, their realization and thoughts about themselves as being God's chosen people. Jesus tells this story to people who would have been aghast at what he was saying. It starts off with the younger son going to his father and basically saying, "I wish you were dead. I want my share of the property now." The property for a family would be their share in the land, the blessed land that God had given to them. It was from that land that all that they had would derive their wealth, their home, the animals, the food that they would grow was dependent upon that property. The younger son doesn't wait for his father. He doesn't want to be part of the family business, which he would inherit his part of, and which would feed him and his family. He decides, "No, I want to do it my way. I want to go off." And he basically wishes his father dead. The father, and the biggest and most important point of this story will come really next week when we look at the nature of the father. But in this first week together, we see that the father does the most incredible thing. He actually gives over to his son half of the property. And then the son, rather than keeping it and using it, he sells it. It's like selling all the family silver. He sells it and he takes the money he has and wastes it. And he ends up even worse than that. For the people who are listening to Jesus, the thought of someone then having to go and work with pigs, which were seen as being animals which would defile them, and even wanting to eat what the pigs had to eat, Jesus in the story is laying it on with a trowel. He's making it quite clear that what this young son has done is just completely unacceptable, unforgivable, people would say. Which of course sets up what the father will do and the father's welcome as he accepts him back, and how extraordinary and unconditional that is. Within the parable, Jesus is talking to people, and still in many parts of the world, people would be appalled at the idea of the son just going off. You don't do that. You don't sell the family property, the family land. The son goes away, but then he comes to his senses. There is a theme that runs right through what Jesus is saying, is that here he is proclaiming God's kingdom. And he is proclaiming it to people who have taken what God has given them and started to use it as though it's their own, making their own rules, ignoring the conventions, ignoring the fact that what they have is actually something truly to be shared and used for all. Now, before we are too critical of people involved at the time of Jesus, I wonder whether we can see any similarities between people who have effectively gone to the Father and said, "No, I don't want to do things your way, God. I want to do things my way. I want to make myself happy, doing things the way I think I'll make myself happy." Jesus is saying to those who are listening to him, "Right, the Father has acted. I have come. I have come to call people to repent, to realize that they've gone off in the wrong direction, that they've gone to the far country, that they've squandered the trust, the stewardship that God had offered to them. And now it's time for them to come back. It is time for people to repent and for there to be a party, as we'll think about next week, as the Father welcomes and embraces them, as Jesus does within his ministry. We are in a world where perhaps even now, or especially now maybe, we need to look and see, have we taken and squandered much of the family silver, looking for our own ends, our own wants, thinking about what we want to have rather than our responsibility to use the land that God has given us for the good of the family, God's family, which is each and every one of us, and the animals and all the creatures he created too. We perhaps need to look at the younger son and think whether we need to come to our senses, because the call to repentance is what is the beginning of every part of the message of Jesus. Repent, the kingdom is coming. We're now going to listen to a piece of music. Rihanna Parker has once again sung a lovely piece for us. It's "To Make You Feel My Love."
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, as we think together today of the parable of the prodigal son, we remember the way in which your son opened wide his arms for us upon the cross, but also in the welcome and embrace that he gave to those who came to him. And so, Father, we bring before you the ways in which we have turned away and turned aside, gone off into a far country, pursuing our own wants. The times when we've been selfish, thoughtless, and unkind. Heavenly Father, we pray that you will help us daily to see our need, to repent, to turn around, to turn back, to follow the path that your Son has laid before us, to walk in the ways of forgiveness, of reconciliation, of truth, of peace, of justice, of love. Father, as we pray for ourselves, we bring before you a world where so often false gods, false paths are set before people. We pray for those who have run off to a far country to satisfy themselves solely. We pray that they may indeed come to their senses. Heavenly Father, we pray too for those who cry out because they are separated from those they love. We pray for those forced to do long, arduous jobs, perhaps for little pay. For all those who, even in today's world, are slaves to others. We pray for the isolated, the lonely, the bereaved. We pray that they may know your love and your embrace. And we pray that you will help us to be ambassadors for your Son, sharing and bringing that love, that acceptance, that welcome to those who need it in our world. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, your homes, and those you love, today and forever. Amen.